part four here, we're going to cover some of the less tested essay subjects. Keep in mind that these have been coming up recently, just not always, on every Michigan bar exam. So they're technically less tested, but you still need to know the highly tested topics within these subjects very well, because it's likely that you're going to see some of these less tested essay subjects on your exam. So we're going to start with agency. Agencies come up a lot recently. You can see it came up in February 2020, February 2019, July 2018, both exams in 2016. And honestly, agency is not that hard to learn, especially in compared with something like corporations. And oftentimes, if agency is tested, something like corporations won't be tested. Occasionally, they'll both be tested, though. Like they were both tested in February 2020. You want to know actual authority, apparent authority, and ratification at a minimum, because these are concepts that come up in, you know, virtually every time agency is tested. It's actually an easy essay question. So if it comes up, you should be thrilled and you should get a high score on it. Basically, you should put in the minimum effort to learn these highly tested concepts, especially that something like apparent authority and actual authority, which you should basically be expected to address in most agency questions. But even ratification, which came up twice in 2016, I saw some people write things like, can't remember what the concept is, starts with an R. It would be better if you could avoid writing something like that and just know some of this key vocab in an agency question. Creditors' rights, keep in mind that not all courses cover garnishments, to my knowledge, unless they've changed things, but you really want to review all of these past creditors' rights issues, July 2019, February 2018, both exams in 2017, because this has come up basically once a year, and it's something that the board can easily trick people with, since a lot of people don't review things like garnishments at all prior to the Michigan Bar exam. Okay, conflict of laws. This comes up when the question is which state's law applies. If the question is whether federal or state law applies, then it's an Erie issue. Erie hasn't been tested since 1997. You know, I don't think our current board that's composed of practicing attorneys and judges really understand Erie either. So I don't anticipate that coming up. If it's about what court can hear the case, it could be a subject matter jurisdiction issue or whatever. But conflict of laws is what state's law apply. You know, like, is it Michigan? Is it Illinois? Which state's law should we apply to this issue? That's how you know it's a conflict issue. They repeatedly test contract and tort issues. I would look at all of these recent exams where it's been tested because, again, it's the best way to get exposed to how they'll probably test it in the future. You should know for contracts, Michigan uses the most significant relationship test, which analyzes five factors, which we've listed here. For torts, they'll go through this two-part analysis of whether a foreign state has an interest in having this law applied. And then if so, then Michigan law will look at some factors from the restatement of conflicts. Some people go into a long historical background of conflicts of law when they get to these questions. The board is not really looking for that. They're looking for, you know, application of one of these tests typically on a conflict of laws question. So even if your commercial course teaches you a long historical background of conflicts, great, it's not bad to know, but I wouldn't necessarily regurgitate that on a Michigan bar exam. Commercial paper and negotiable instruments has only been tested twice in the history of the bar exam. I don't anticipate it coming up a lot more, but again, you cannot ignore it in case it is tested. They tested it in February 2010, which was truly a straight negotiable instruments question, very difficult. They also tested it in July 2019. Honestly, you could have gotten a high score on that July 2019 bar exam with knowing very little about negotiable instruments because a lot of it was kind of contracts-y. But you should still know especially the basics and the vocab with negotiable instruments and commercial paper. You should be able to define negotiable instrument, know what a holder in due course is, analyze these past essays where this has been tested closely, because if it comes up again, it could very well look like one of these two essay exams. Partnership. Surprisingly to me, it has not been tested as much. Partnership was tested in July 2007 and then again in February 2017. They've really, you know, of the kind of businessy subjects like corporations, agency, and partnership, they've kind of stuck to testing corporations and then agency. So partnership hasn't come up very frequently. You should definitely know the basics of partnership formation. Know that there are no formalities required to form a general partnership. Like, you don't have to file a certificate or anything like that. A partnership is just a voluntary association of two or more people with legal capacity to carry on as co-owners of business for profit. So if two people decide they're going to carry on as co-owners of business for profit, then they're partners, even if they don't call themselves partners. Profit sharing is prima facie evidence of a partnership unless it's used to pay back a debt or pay wages or something like that. I would recommend that you look at that February 2017 essay question and then also go back further and look at July 2007, look at February 1998, February 1995. Hopefully your bar review course has these essay questions available to you, since if you only rely on the Michigan Board of Law Examiners website, you're only going to really be able to practice one question at this point. Okay, equity. They just tested this equity subject recently in February 2020. They've tested it multiple times though since 2016. And really when they've tested equity, they've just tested preliminary injunctions, these four factors for injunctive relief. It doesn't mean they might switch it up. They could test whatever they wanted, but preliminary injunction seems to be their favorite thing to test. People for some reason still don't memorize these four factors. We use the mnemonic HELP. They still don't know them, and they still get the essay wrong, even though it's tested virtually the same way every time it's been tested. So I would make sure that you know this background on what a preliminary injunction is. Know that it's extraordinary relief. Memorize these four HELP factors. Okay, harm, evaluate the risk, look at the likelihood of prevailing in the public interest. Memorize these, be able to apply them. Note that in most cases, irreparable harm isn't present, and so the injunction will not be granted. That's typically how these essays turn out. Again, I'm not saying that you'll see an essay, you know, that doesn't turn out this way, because you could see something tested in a different way, but typically these essays have tested the same law in the same way. So make sure that you memorize this law and then review these past essays to see how it's applied, because this should be another one where if you see it, you should be thrilled and you should get a 9 or a 10. No-fault insurance, they really like to test non-economic damages. It's their favorite thing to test. You should know that the No-Fault Act generally bars actions for non-economic damages like pain and suffering unless somebody suffered death, permanent serious disfigurement, or serious impairment of a body function. Serious impairment of a body function is typically what's tested. Review these past essays. I find that a lot of people will know a bunch of nuances about no-fault that have never been tested and probably won't be tested. So while you want to be familiar with Michigan's no-fault law, of course, this is what you really want to know, like the back of your hand, and focus on when you study, because it's very likely to come up if you see no-fault tested. Secured transactions can be tricky, especially if you didn't take it in law school. You want to know that Article 9 applies. You want to know the basics of classifying goods, particularly into things like consumer goods, inventory, and equipment. Farm products hasn't been tested. Some people focus a lot on the tangibles and general intangibles and things like that. Honestly, that has not been tested super frequently or recently on the Michigan bar exam. You should know what attachment is, know what perfection is, be very familiar with purchase money security interests. Some things, you know, aren't tested as much, but these basic concepts are concepts that you should definitely be aware of and be able to apply on the bar exam. Because if you see something basic tested, you should hopefully be able to get a high score. You'll be competing with people who have not reviewed secured transactions, hoping that it wouldn't be tested on the bar exam. So hopefully you'll look pretty good if you see a secured trans essay question tested. So that's an overview of some of the less tested subjects. But again, these subjects have been coming up a lot recently. You want to review all the subjects. You don't want to ignore any subject. Don't ignore equity or agency or whatever because it's not tested as much. You still want to review it. But when you review these subjects, what you want to focus on is the highly tested areas, because for most of them, you're going to see something that's highly tested or semi-predictable. You cannot learn everything about all 24 areas of law in the Michigan bar exam. It's impossible, and you don't have to know everything to pass the Michigan bar exam. Of course, you're going to see something that throws you off. You're going to see something that maybe you're not comfortable with. You would see that no matter what you did to prepare for the bar exam, because the bar exam is tricky. That's just the nature of the bar exam. But to study effectively and study smart, don't ignore any subject. Instead, review all subjects, focusing on the highly tested topics within each subject. So hopefully this helps give you a good overview of how to approach these topics on the Michigan bar exam.